Hello dear children, we were doing the adventure of Toto since 2 days. Now this is going to be your fourth video describing and explaining the chapter The Adventure of Toto. We had seen that how adventurous the monkey Toto was. He was always ready to merrymaking, fun, cracking jokes, though he was creating, while he was enjoying doing all these things, but he used to create trouble for others. But today we are going to encounter one experience where Toto the monkey was in trouble because of his overexcited nature. We got to know that always Toto was very careful while he was bathing inside the cold water. He always used to check the temperature of water, and he used to imitate Ruskin Bond while going into the water, because and till the water remained warm, he used to be there inside the water. Let's continue from one comfortable, he would take the soap in his hands or feet and rub himself all over. He was not only bathing himself by dipping into the cold water, but as we all are aware that human beings are transformed version of monkeys. So the monkey Toto was also imitating human beings in each and every action. He was using soap also while bathing. So when he was absolutely comfortable inside the water temperature, then he used to rub soap all along his body. When the water became cold, he would get out and run as quickly as he could to the kitchen fire in order to dry himself. So he used to sit inside the water till it was warm. Then he used to come out and sit near the fireplace in the kitchen. And those time that actual fire, earthen fire, used to be used for cooking food. He used to sit near the fire so that to dry himself. If anyone laughed at him during this performance, his bath performance, Toto's feeling would be hurt and he would refuse to go on with his bath. See, during the entire process, if anybody would make fun of him, then he used to stop taking part in bathing, and he used to refuse it for many days. One day Toto nearly succeeded in boiling himself alive, but one day what happens, due to his excitement, he was about to boil himself. What was the incident? Let's start. A large kitchen kettle had been left on the fire to boil for tea, and Toto, finding himself with nothing better to do, decided to remove the lid meaning cover. Once a big kettle was kept on fire for tea. So many people must be there, that's why a good amount of tea water was boiling. And Toto came into kitchen and he found so much water was boiling. So he removed the cover of that kettle. Finding the water just warm enough for a bath, he got in with his head sticking out from the open kettle. Now he found that the water was warm. So he considered every warm water is for his bathing, and he get into the water. His head was out from the kettle. This was just fine for a while, until the water began to boil. Toto then raised himself a little, but finding it cold enough outside, sat out again. See what happened when Toto first duration of time he was quite comfortable. Later on, when it started boiling, he wanted to come out. He stood up also, but outside it was very cold. So he denied to come out from water and he remained into the water only. Toto then raised himself a little, but finding, see, he sat down again inside the water because it was very cold outside. He continued hopping up, but out up and down for some time until grandmother arrived and hauled him half boiled out of the kettle. He was just doing it again and again, coming out, feeling cold, getting inside. But it was good that grandmother came at time and she removed it from the kettle. Otherwise, he would have been boiled completely at that day. If there is a part of that brain especially devoted to mischief, that part was largely developed in Toto. If there is a writer, Ruskin Bond is saying, if there is a part God is developing for mischief, so a part, that part was absolutely very furnished in Toto. He was ready, you know, always first in each and every sort of mischief. He was always tearing things to pieces. Whenever one of my aunt came near him, he made every effort to get hold to her dress and tear a hole in it. Whatever came, whatever used to come in his hand, he used to tear it up. And whatever any aunt used to visit my family, that time Toto was every time just touching their dress and making at least a hole in their dress. It used to be his regular task. One day at lunchtime, a large dish of pulao stood in the center of the dining table. We entered the room to find Toto stuffing himself with rice. My grandmother screamed, meaning shouted, and Toto threw a plate at her. One day, lunchtime was there, grandmother prepared lunch and a plate of pulao was kept on the dining table. But Toto ate entire pulao, and when grandmother shouted, he had thrown the plate at her. One of my aunts rushed forward and received a glass of water in the face. One of his aunts came near to him to stop his activity, but Toto threw a glass of water on her face. When grandfather arrived, Toto picked up the dish of pulao and made his exit through a window. When grandfather came, Toto ran away from window. We found him in the branches of a jackfruit tree. The dish is still in his arm. He remained there all afternoon, eating slowly through the rice, determined on finding every grain. While Toto ran away, so that time rice plate was with him, and he just sat down on a jackfruit tree, and during the entire day time he ate each and every piece of rice. And then, in order to spite grandmother who had screamed at him, he threw the dish down from the tree and chattered with delight when it broke into 100 pieces. And now he wanted to teach a lesson to grandmother because she shouted on him. So he had thrown a dish or plate from the tree and the dish was broken into 1,000 pieces. Obviously, Toto was not the sort of pet we could keep for long. Even grandfather realized that we were not well to do and could not afford the frequent loss of dishes, clothes, curtains and wallpaper. So grandfather found the Tonga driver and sold Toto back to him for only 3 rupees. But obviously Toto was very expensive to have. So grandfather again sold Toto back to him because that 3 rupees only, because so many clothes, curtain, wallpaper, it was too much for them to tolerate every now and then. Thank you, dear children.